shit. What up, guys?
Oh, hey. There we go. Hey. We're live.
Woo.
Finally.
So we're on Twitch. Yes. You should be watching on Twitch right now. So I'm saying hi, Twitch. Because for some reason, I don't know what happened, we can't stream on YouTube. So,
sad face.
That's weird.
I apologize for false advertisement because we put in, you know, http://gaming.youtube.com/zoomingames. But welcome to Big Red Lazor. I'm Tamtu.
I'm Viet.
And that is
Hilda.
It says Hilda. It says Hilda, but it's not really. She also has technical difficulties in the form and shape of someone jumping in front of the train, thus causing her to be delayed. She will be here sooner than later. Hopefully.
So who am I?
You are Mr. Bench.
Mr. Bench. I'm sitting on the bench.
No, regulars know that he was here last week. Mr. Eric, how are you today?
I'm great. I'm fine.
Yeah. How was your week?
Happy to be here. Good.
How was Big Red Lazor for you last week?
Amazing. I mean, we could watch the booty of Lara all the time.
That's the most important.
Yeah.
That's how we roll. Okay.
Exactly. I don't care about the game. I only care about the booty.
The booty. Yeah. How has your week been?
It was okay. It was good. Today,
NDA. We can't say a damn thing about how awesome our day was this morning.
Yeah.
But now today's awesome as well because it's time for Big Red Lazor. So I want to say hello to Kate, who isn't here. She is in Mallorca.
Yes. Again.
Let's see. Daniel Delgado is here. Tristan Davery, Georgia. Sophian Kluft, Face, and many more people. I hope people have been moving from YouTube to Twitch now.
Yes, me too.
So before we dive into the games, the Game Awards happened last night. And I wanted to see what your reactions are to the winners. So let's start from the top. Okay, so the game of the year, not our game of the year, which you can still vote for, but the game of the year at the Game Awards. There was Bloodborne as a nominee, Fallout 4, Metal Gear Solid 5, Super Mario Maker, and The Witcher 3. Yes. Winner, The Witcher 3.
It's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Yeah?
It's a good game.
It was bound to be one of those open world games.
Yeah.
So it was either Fallout... To me, it was basically between Fallout 4, MGS 5, and The Witcher 3. So not really as much of a surprise.
Mario love here.
There's plenty of Mario love today.
Thank God.
Coming up, Developer of the Year, CD Projekt Red.
Of course.
Makes sense, as they made the only game this year that pretty much had zero DLC issues.
Yeah.
Like, people actually enjoyed the game without having to worry about a season pass or DLC, because the first few batches of DLC were free.
Yeah.
And then, good quality expansions that you had to pay for, but they let people know in advance. So, yeah. GG CD Projekt Red.
Yep.
Give it up for the Polish people. Best indie game from out of Axiom Verge, which is actually a pretty cool game. Her Story, Ori and the Blind Forest, Undertale, which has garnered a lot of hype the past few weeks. Mm-hmm. But the winner, Rocket League.
Of course.
Great game.
And it's
great
coming game. To Xbox.
Yes.
It's coming to Xbox.
Finally.
Okay, cool. Xbox One.
I hope it will be free.
Best mobile handheld game, Downwell, Fallout Shelter, Lara Croft Go, Monster Hunter 4, Ultimate Pac-Man 256. Winner is Lara Croft Go.
Haven't played the game.
I heard a lot of good things about it, actually.
Does she have booty in that game?
Plenty of booty.
Most likely.
All right, now, so the best narrative at the Game Awards went to... the winner went to Her Story. That's one of the games that was very under my radar.
Very.
Also, news-wise, I barely read anything about it, but apparently
haven't
it was
played
really good. It went
I
up against...
I haven't heard it. I heard of it even until the Game
against
Awards.
Against what?
I haven't heard of it until...
Until Dawn.
Until Dawn.
No, Until Dawn was also one of the nominees, along with The Witcher Wild Hunt, Tales from the Borderlands, and Life is Strange. Best art direction went to Ori and the Blind Forest, which I actually very much agree with. Best score soundtrack to Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain. Now, did you guys hear about how Kojima was barred?
Yeah. Yep.
Barred by Konami lawyers to go to LA to receive, to accept the awards.
Yep. They should be ashamed of themselves. Yeah.
Everyone is really hating Konami right now.
Of course.
More than they already do.
Question is, who is picking up Kojima right now?
Yeah.
Yeah. We don't know because like, he deserves a big studio and a big publisher. So
yeah, for sure. Thankfully, Kiefer Sutherland accepted the award on his behalf. The voice actor for Big Boss. Also very controversial because all the David Hayter fans were very, very passionate about that.
Yeah.
Best performance goes to Her Story again. Interesting. Best shooter is not highlighted. Shame on you, GameSpot. Best action adventure game, Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yep.
Best RPG, not highlighted. GG.
Fought for.
Best fighting game. Okay, this is kind of funny. Okay, the nominees were Guilty Gear Xrd, Rise of the Incarnates. Heard of it?
Nope.
Rising Thunder?
Heard of it, but haven't seen anything of it.
Nope.
And Mortal Kombat X.
Yeah, well, that's kind of obvious.
And the clear winner is the best Mortal Kombat X.
Yeah, of course.
You know, it's like, if you win the best of the worst, does that make you better than the worst of the best?
Food for thought.
Food for thought. Best family game. Dun, dun, dun. Super Mario Maker.
Oh, of course. That too.
Best multiplayer, Splatoon.
Of course. Ooh. They also were the best shooter.
Really?
Yeah, I've seen that.
Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. Over?
Over Black Ops and all the other ones.
Probably.
Yeah.
Over.
Correct me if I'm wrong. But
over Halo 5 Guardian, not surprised. Over Star Wars Battlefront, not surprised.
I thought so.
Over Destiny the Taken King.
Oh, God.
Easy.
Easy.
No.
Easy.
Easy. No. Easy. No.
No. No competition.
It's not better than Splatoon.
This is when fanboying jumps in.
Okay. But there were also some... what do we call it? Fan favorites. Fan votes. Esports Player of the Year goes to Kenny S, who we interviewed during Gamescom.
Yes.
It was very cool. So good to see you back. And Esports Game of the Year, CSGO.
Yep. It's it's funny because League of Legends and Dota were like the two major ones. Mm-hmm. But CSGO, because it's growing so quickly and a lot more people are watching it, I think that's why it won.
Yeah. And the last one I want to bring up is Trending Gamer. Not PewDiePie. Not Markiplier. Not Total Biscuit. Greg Miller. Good guy. I like it.
Mm-hmm.
I like him. He deserves it. So, Game Awards. How do you feel about that nowadays? Is it necessary?
I think it's like... It's like people always see this as like, you know, the Oscars of games, you know, and to me it's not really necessary. It's there just to, you know, bring highlights on what came out this year. And because, you know, most of these things you can already expect, like, you know, who's going to win the best sports game, for example.
Well, no, but I did not see Rocket League winning best sports game this year. Usually it's FIFA or PES or whatever.
Yeah,
Madden.
Madden.
Fuck Madden.
Yeah, we need such a thing like an award show. But the thing is, I do like the BAFTAs. These are British award show thingy.
Focused on the industry too.
Yeah, yeah, and that's more important for me.
Yeah, they're like the BAFTAs are actually also one of the few outlets that recognize the video game industry as performance,
as
an art too.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
I think gaming still has a long way to go.
Yeah,
very long.
Yeah, I mean,
it's not that level yet.
Yeah, I mean, we only have multi-million tournaments going on.
It's not enough.
We're only a billion-dollar industry.
Not enough.
Billions of industry.
We're being compared to actual sports, you know, but it's not enough.
No, not enough. And why? Just cause. Just cause. In case you guys are wondering where Tim is behind the scenes today. He wanted to try out new ventures today. and see what it's like behind the scenes. I guess he misses switching the show from here.
Yeah.
But since we don't have that anymore, he's behind the scenes now. Yes. If we had a behind the scenes cam, we would switch to it. Guys, if that's an idea, behind the scenes cam, not possible?
Nope.
Not possible? Oh, one says it's possible. The other one just flipped me off. Not now.
In the future.
So, in the future. Tim, people want to know how your week has been. So type it in the chat. He and Robert will be manning it. Yeah. And we're still waiting for Hilda. So while we're waiting for Miss Hilda Wereld, how about we switch over to Just Cause 3 to...
I think that's a great idea.
See lots of explosions. Yeah.
Explosions. I love me some explosions.
Me too.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh,
wow. Hey, what happened here?
I thought, instead of shooting this guy, I could hang him off a billboard and then, just chill next to him, Like look, I'm just chilling with my homies.
Chilling with the villain.
Yeah. How's it hanging, buddy?
Wow.
This is like showcasing the best feature of Just Cause, which is the grappling hook.
Yeah.
And they basically improved on it like a million times in comparison to Just Cause.
Can we go back to the guy?
Wait.
Look at that.
Yeah, just look at him. He's like, okay, what I can do
just
is
do
I can
it.
I can make him fall and I can do it again.
Really?
So, yeah. I can basically shoot at him and then just there we go. Fire it off and then pull him in.
Oh, hey, now you fixed the slime too.
Exactly. Yeah. And now he's just hanging there. So yeah, with the grappling hook, you can now basically hook to launch yourself, but you can also hook two things together and pull them next to each other. So I can demonstrate that right now.
You can basically do anything.
Yeah, you can basically do anything you want. Okay, just let me get like...
You can tether everything.
Okay, let's tether that chair to that house.
Oh, okay, so let's start simple.
Okay, we got a chair, and then we tether it to the house, and then now...
You always wanted to do this.
And now it's possible. Just reel it in, boys.
Next gen gaming, guys.
Oh, and it disappears. Yeah, Just Cause is not without its bugs, and also with its clunky controls. Mm-hmm. That's what I realized playing this game, that like the controls are quite clunky, and they're not always on point. But, you can hijack cars as well. Oh, wait, let me...
So, what about the gaming world? Where are we right now?
We are in...
Medici. This is actually Rico's hometown.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's currently being... it's being taken over by a dictator, and he's gonna take back his hometown. Yeah.
Okay, so...
such a good story, man.
So, this is the map. It's really big, actually. Like, you have here the islands, and then here you have the mainland is here.
Oh, damn.
But, like, this is the whole map. Like, look at it. Look at how many areas you can take over and take back. The blue areas are controlled by the rebels, which is where you are part of. Yeah, our side. And the reds are controlled by the army. I think it's called the army or the I don't know what they're called anymore. But in any case, you start off here in this area, Baia, and you're supposed to take it. And how do you take over an area? By going to these safe houses or just power plants or.
And just disable them or just overrun
them, overrun them, and kill off all the enemies there, and then let your rebels in. So that's what we're going to do now.
Yeah.
We're going to go to this point and take it over.
How powerful is your grappling crotch kick?
Grappling crotch kick. I haven't tried the crotch kick yet, but you can...
I challenge you to do 10 of them right now.
10? Okay, well...
I'm going to count.
I know... Oh. All right. So I know I can grapple to them and then like kick them in the face, but I don't know about the crotch
kick. Yeah, kick them in the face.
Oh yeah, just
kick them.
Do 10 grapple attacks. Kick.
Okay, so we're in Fortaleza, and basically here, how to take it over? You have to destroy the military assets that are shown on the side.
Okay, and that's it. Basically a checklist.
Yeah, police station.
You have to destroy everything.
Yeah, it's actually a lot easier than you think it is. Hold on.
So this game is just basically tells you to break shit.
Yeah, basically. Yeah. So for example, if you want to, you have to destroy one of these. It's like a propaganda speaker.
Mm-hmm.
So what I usually do is I just connect it to like something else and then just pull it apart.
Oh.
And there we go. That's the first thing you have to destroy. And here, these are the militia. And so now
grapple him!
Oh, wait. Whoops. That was a fail. All right, let's grapple him. Oh, I failed again.
Step your game up.
And let's grapple him to there. And whee!
Oh, okay. That's beautiful.
The next militia I see, I'm going to kick him in the face.
Oh, heat level? They have heat level here too?
Yeah, they have heat level, and it's hilariously easy to get rid of them. You basically just have to hide, and then you have to, just kill all of them, basically.
Mm-hmm. There's almost no gravity in this game.
There is no gravity in this game. Right. You can just basically do whatever you want. Kick him in the face! Oh, yeah! Oh, and then of course you can shoot too when things get to that point. Oh, hold on. Yeah, this might not be a good idea, so let me get out of here.
You almost died,
why?
Man.
Because.
So you also have a rocket launcher on your back.
I know. Oh, Jesus. Right, let's get out.
Give him a bitch slap.
Whee!
Through the tree.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Then there's a police station. You have to destroy that too. So.
How do you destroy?
Oh yeah. You destroy like the fuel tanks that they have, and then you take it over by letting your rebels in.
Because every police station has fuel tanks. Yeah. Right?
Exactly. They have every police station apparently in Medici.
This is such a realistic game.
Have this huge oil tank right here, just waiting for you to blow up. So, yeah, again, let's
it's
just...
not guarded at all.
Let's just...
Oh, no, there are guards there.
Okay. Oh, yeah, two guards.
Hold on. Whoops. That's
you tether that fence.
Tether the wrong thing again. All right. Really? Okay, well, least it's out of the way now.
Yeah, the whole building.
So then let's just...
That would be fun.
Come on. Tether. There we go. Really?
There we go. Yeah.
Oh, no, it didn't kill the guys. Aww.
Wait for it.
I was expecting to run. Okay.
Boom. Nice.
There we go. Okay, so then now I have to, let's see, call in the rebels.
Kill some more guys.
Yeah. Oh. So let me just open this gate so that my rebels can go in.
Why?
Because then we can take it over.
No,
and then
just
I thought this was a one-man show, but you also
exactly
have
right
another
yeah
troops of rebels and shit. That's amazing.
Because why not? So, I know you also played a lot of GTA 5.
Yeah.
How are the controls compared to this? Is it similar?
Oh, this is it's a lot clunkier, that's for sure. Come here. Let's let them in again. And so, okay, so now we've taken over the police station. So that's one of the objectives approved again. They've got to kill people.
So you have like checklist.
Yeah, you basically have a checklist of things that you have to do in order to take over the town.
So it's basically fantasy life, but a lot more violent.
Fantasy life?
Yeah.
You have to take over towns too?
No, it was basically a to-do list.
Oh, okay.
It also has a to-do list.
Oh, jeez. All right, come here, you.
Kick you in the face!
Yeah!
Come on.
Kick you in the
you
face.
Should die, man. Oh, you're almost dying.
It's fine.
It's Rico, fine.
Because Rico doesn't die.
Ah.
Rico flies around. Boom.
3, 2, 4.
All right. Where's the... And they're not going to leave me. Oh, wait. Oh, I have to get this thing, too.
Oh, kill it.
Oh, whoops. Oh. I basically just kicked the civilian in the face.
I'll count that as 5.
So this is a propaganda truck, and you have to.
So then what I gotta do? So right, what
you
I
have to
do,
destroy it.
Yeah, I'm gonna drive it off this cliff.
Yeah.
Yep. There Boom. We go. That's one of them. Oh yeah, and you gotta destroy a statue as well. Okay, let's find that statue, and then we're gonna.
How many ways can we destroy a statue?
Well, you can, there's like, you can blow it up, or you can, like, drag it to the ground. Basically, that's how you destroy things in Just Cause 2, guys. Either blow it up, or drag it to the ground with your grappling gun, rope. Which is surprisingly very powerful. Because you can pull down oil tankers and shit, so.
Oil tankers?
Yeah. Apparently, you can, like, tether it to an oil tanker and then take it down.
So, I understand that this game is really realistic.
It's very realistic. I mean, like, look at me. Look at me. Like, and then I have unlimited parachutes as well.
Oh, unlimited parachutes.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
It's very helpful. Oh, yeah, there's a statue. Hold on. Oh. Let me just drag this down to the ground and then we can kill the statue.
But you have to blow it up.
You can blow it up or like I said,
you break should it blow down. It up. That's what I'm saying.
I lost count, guys. I think we were at 5, right?
All right, let's blow it up. Oh, shit.
Oh.
Ow.
Someone blows you up.
Ah, come on, Rico, get out of there.
What the fuck happened?
I have no idea. Something just blew up in my face.
That's what she said.
He misses the hand.
Yeah, well, now he's gone. All right, let's shoot.
He misses
this
a body.
Thing. Okay, so let's see. I need one. Oh, there. There's the last one.
You see.
Yeah,
you your see checklist. That okay. The icons are the checklist.
Okay, so I need to destroy billboards and a projector. But that's also one of the problems with this game. Like, it doesn't have any prompts. So then you have to look for the things yourself.
Oh,
so like
okay.
The
so no quest markers or whatever.
No quest markers.
Are you sure?
Yeah. I tried it. Like, I tried lame. Zooming into the map, like, 50 times. But it doesn't... Oh, here's a billboard. So let's destroy that one.
Mm-hmm.
And see how powerful your rope is? It's like you can just basically pull anything into each other. Oh, look. Oh, crap. All right. It's a group of them, so... Let's do the only way you can do it.
Oh, civilians!
Oh.
Why doesn't this game? It's called Rope Man.
Grapple Man.
Grapple Man.
It's
the
he's
power
like,
up of
he's
Infinity.
Like the Mexican
grapples.
Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Oh, there's another billboard. And also, it's hilarious. Like, you basically blew up half of a town, but if you run away from the guards and they don't see you for a while, it's like, oh, call off the search, guys. He's gone.
Nothing happened.
He's gone. Nothing happened.
Yeah, time for my siesta.
Yeah. Nothing happened, guys. Okay, so one more billboard and a projector, which I have no idea what it is. That's going to be a problem. It's like, it's probably red. Like a car driving around, I guess.
What's a projector?
I have no idea, man. I wish I could tell you.
Maybe something that projects... propaganda movies on a wall?
Probably.
Inside a house? So you can't
see
it from
outside?
A house.
I gotta find the third billboard first. It's like... This is the only frustrating... Like, oh,
have you
is.
Been
oh,
on a plane
is.
Yet?
Yes. In the beginning, you start off on a plane. And guess how you start? You start off on a plane, and then you jump on top of the plane to shoot down anti-air missiles.
Wow.
With a rocket launcher on a plane.
You also started the second game in a plane, right? With
skydiving
down.
Yeah, and then
down,
you skydive. So. Oh.
So I guess that's a just cause thing.
Oh shit! What the
start
fuck?
The game.
Why?
In a plane.
Oh, it's a helicopter. Hold on.
Just cause.
Let me get that helicopter. Oh yeah, I know. So
tethered the helicopter to the car, dude.
Oh man, too late. It's
where
killing
is it?
Me.
Oh, yeah.
It's killing me. Oh hey, get the fuck out of the way. Yeah. Okay, so now projector.
This is like Michael Bay the movie.
Yeah, basically.
The game. Michael Bay the game.
Michael Bay the movie the game.
Michael Bay the movie the game.
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, so projector. Projector. Now, if I was a projector in Medici, where would I be?
It should be a truck or something like that, I guess.
Yeah, I know. It's
the
like
icon
it
looks like a truck.
It looks like a truck. It looks like a carrot. Oh, there.
Oh, there,
oh, there are actually markers.
You were lying.
I was lying, guys. There are actually markers in this game. I just wanted to make it difficult for you guys. Okay, so then we are to go there. So fly some more. Okay, so then...
You also have to raise the flag.
Yeah, but the flag is here, so that's no problem.
Okay.
Yeah, but you can only raise the flag after you destroyed everything.
Where's the projector?
Yeah. It's here, this thing. Okay. Well, let's
see, it does exactly what I said it did. Just turn around to the right. Turn to the right. See? It projects to a wall.
Okay.
Propaganda.
Nobody's watching, but that doesn't matter.
Oh.
Holy
oh
fuck.
My god.
That was
did
dumb.
You ju-
I just blew myself up.
Hilda.
What?
I need you right now.
Yes.
I need you right now to slap this noob in the face.
So yeah, I just blew myself up.
And I you know, and ending with a bang, right?
Yeah.
Ending it with a bang.
Well, guys, that was Just Cause 3.
The bad thing about this is this wasn't on purpose.
No. It wasn't on purpose. Yeah,
it's a surprise.
I was gonna end it with me taking over the town, but you know, this works too. Oh god. Yeah, guys, so that was Just Cause 3, and basically a lot of explosions. Lot of grappling around.
Explosions.
Seriously, it's a game where you can just really mindlessly blow things up and have fun with. Mm-hmm. The controls are clunky, you can do whatever you want, so buggy, but it's so fun.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'll be sure to snag it if I feel like having a bad day. It's like, you know what?
Yeah.
I need to blow shit up.
Yes, exactly.
And then I'll just play Just Cause 3. All right. Okay, Eric, thanks for joining us
for
just a little bit. Our guest has arrived.
I know.
So it's time for a big switcheroony to start up this next segment.
Here. Get over here.
Exactly. Ah. That was Michael Bay, the movie, the game. Thanks. And this is Hilda. Hilda. You don't have to put it.
You don't have to do that.
I want to.
Oh.
Oh.
Okay.
Such a pro.
I know.
So professional.
Hello.
Professional Hirudaru.
I don't know how this works.
So, how was your trip here?
Mm-hmm.
Is this right?
I think so.
Wow, you have a tiny ear.
I know.
Yeah, adjust the rubber band.
Yeah. Okay, hold on. Let me make
so it smaller.
That it fits you. Oh, God.
Put it on my ear.
There we go.
And aim it down, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, there we go. There we go.
I got it. Hi, sorry.
Welcome to Big Red Lazor, Hilda.
Thanks.
How was your trip here?
Horrible.
Why? Did someone die?
Maybe. I don't know. Something happened and I couldn't leave for like 2 hours.
Of all places.
I know.
You were stuck in Helmond.
I know. It's
where is Helmond?
I don't know,
next
man.
To Eindhoven.
You
where
would
I
know.
Used to live, yeah.
You would know.
I would know, and I know not to go to Helmond.
Okay.
Because there's nothing there.
Don't go there. But just yeah, there weren't like any buses or anything going, so I was like, nope. Eh.
No backup?
No backup, man. And I was planning
just
to leave.
Just because it's Friday, guys. Maybe they were anticipating
yeah.
Big Red Lazor, just waiting for Big Red Lazor.
Yeah. Every time I go here, I leave like way early, so I'm here like an hour ahead of time, and then I am late every time.
I love your shirt.
Thanks, yeah. Man.
Nice shirt.
All right, so Kate is in the chat.
Yay!
So she's still here in a way. keeping company, keeping everyone here company. She says hi.
Hi.
So yeah, I think it's time for the next segment. And that means I'm going to ignore the chat.
Yes.
Because it's time for message received.
Ooh. It's time for message received.
Yeah.
Woo.
What's up, guys? Welcome to Message Received, the segment of Big Red Lazor where we take your messages and receive them and answer them here in the show. I'm joined by Viet and Hilda, our very special guest Hilda today. Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Good to have you here.
Good to be here.
Excellent. Hey, I've got questions for you guys. So let's answer them. I've received messages. And
who receives messages nowadays? Everyone WhatsApp or...
That is a message.
That is a message.
How is
that
not a message? That is a message.
Those are messages that you receive, Viet. And you can send us messages in the app. Or you can reply to the message received video. And also on social media by using the hashtag message received and tag us in it. And we'll pick out a few and put them on these cards right here. I'm going to start off with the first one. It's from Andrew, the sober Irishman carpenter.
Okay.
That's the first sober Irishman I've seen.
I know. He says, hey guys, I'm so glad that BRL is finally back and hope that you are all doing well.
Thank you.
Me too.
My question, Have any of you played any games in the past, whether they were part of one of your favorite franchises or not, where the storyline was a disappointment for you? Follow-up question, if you could make any changes to the storylines of those games, what changes would you make and why? I ask this because I hear that the storyline of Metal Gear Solid 5 was a big letdown for many fans of the series.
That was a long question.
Yeah.
So, what stories in games that you've played have disappointed you?
Life is Strange. I'm bitter about... I will never stop being bitter about that.
Yeah?
Yeah. The ending, like the story was great, and then the ending happened, and then everyone was just meh. Everything was meh for me, and that is the only thing that comes to mind right now because it was just such a big disappointment.
Yeah,
it was just nah.
I feel the same way.
Yeah,
I feel the same way. And the end, it was just out of being a completionist. You know, I just okay, let's get through this.
Yeah.
And then I made one choice, and like okay, well, okay, let's replay that last bit and see what the other choice.
And it was both lame.
Mm-hmm. But up to episodes 4, it was fantastic, though.
Yeah, that is the problem. It just like completely ruined it for me. Like the entire ending was just meh.
Viet, if you could make any changes to a storyline of a game, which one?
It's not so much about changing the storyline. It's just that
that's a cool question.
Yeah. No. I know, but like it's also a change. Basically, just don't make the storyline at all. Because, for example, for me, it was Kingdom Hearts. The extras in Kingdom Hearts that didn't need to happen. The 365 over 2 days and all the other extras as well. I just wish they didn't happen because it kind of ruined the story for me a little bit.
It became too convoluted. Yeah,
exactly. And it's just like, you know, it just feels like unnecessary fillers that shouldn't be there in the first place.
Yeah,
and
but like Birth by Sleep was a prequel.
Yeah, no, that's true, but like, I just feel they weren't necessary, you know, because I just want them to get on to Kingdom Hearts 3 and just, you know, leave the other stuff
fair
out.
Fair enough.
I just want Kingdom Hearts 3, guys.
Fair
make it happen.
Fair enough. 2016.
Be Square patient.
Enix. Square Enix, 2016, Kingdom Hearts 3. Second topic is from Brian Crosby. Not Bill Cosby, Brian Crosby. Hi, hope you are well. We are, thank you.
Yes.
So what do you think of Star Wars Battlefront? Do you think EA messed up or did well? Yes, the sound and graphics are awesome. You've played it.
I've played it. Now, I am not a huge Star Wars fan, so that makes it a little bit different for me. It is fun, but it gets boring real fast.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It looks good, and yeah, the sound, the graphics, and the sounds are all good. It's just
very bare bones.
It's
gameplay wise.
It's just not. It just doesn't bring anything new. It's just a shooter.
It's a missed opportunity.
It really is. It could have been amazing.
Yeah.
I think there should have been some kind of story mode somewhere.
Mostly like the graphics are amazing and the sound design is perfect.
Yeah.
Like when it comes to just that, if you were to judge a game just on those two things, it would be a 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
But then the game itself was just so repetitive, boring, bare bones.
Yeah. It's fun to play for a little bit, but then it's just meh.
No, which is unfortunate. I didn't ask you because you haven't seen Star Wars at all. That will change.
I watched the last one
tomorrow.
Last night.
And?
I watched everything now. It was okay.
Yeah.
They were movies.
Yes.
Do you feel complete now?
No.
No, exactly.
I want to watch 7 and then maybe.
I think I'd feel the same after that.
Maybe you needed to watch it with a drinking game too.
Maybe I needed to watch it when I was 7.
That's an idea.
Yeah. We'll add a drinking game to the marathon tomorrow.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Awesome.
next up is Billy Gonzalez.
Oh.
He wants to know, would you rather have an enormous bushy beard or stay clean shaven?
I would love to have a bushy beard. I think it would look great on me. Are they asking this on purpose because you guys can't grow beards?
I think so.
I'm trying.
Like, to me, the answer is just very simple. Like, stay clean shaven because in order to grow a bushy beard.
Yeah, I see something here.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like 5 hairs.
It just doesn't work for me. Like,
this has been untouched all November because of Movember. But you don't notice any difference. It's not different.
Exactly.
So I would love to have a bushy beard, just, you know, so it matches this future man bun.
Yeah.
Oh God.
It will match this future man bun.
Please don't do that ever.
That's the thing with Asians. Our hair doesn't grow on our face. It grows on our head. So basically, you have like massive hair growth, but no beard growth. And it's just... Sometimes I do wish I have a bushy beard, but for me, it would be clean shaven.
I don't think a beard would look good on you.
You know what? You know who has an epic beard? Dennis.
Oh my
our
god.
Buddy, our buddy Dennis from 2K.
He has the best
he
beard
has the
I have
most
ever
awesome
seen.
Beard ever.
If I could have his beard, I would die a happy
I
man.
I would like to touch his beard one day.
He's like me, but then like the other way around, you know. He doesn't have hair on his head, but like it just goes down there.
It's
yeah.
Like Viking.
Good
yeah.
beards.
All right.
I
Reese.
Enjoy a good beard.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How's Andrew's beard coming along?
It's a bit patchy.
It pokes you.
I hope he's not watching.
Well, keep on growing.
Yeah.
Keep on growing. Keep on trying, boys. Never yep. give up.
Never give up. Never give surrender. Up. All right. Next one is from Reese. He wants to know, have you guys ever played L.A. Noire? And if so, did you like it?
I have played L.A.
Really?
Noire. Yeah.
I have not. So.
I do like it because it's, well, of course, it's a Rockstar game. So then, you know, you kind of get that same feely element to GTA 5 where you explore around a sandbox mm-hmm. game. But I like it mainly because it gives a good vibe of that time, mm-hmm. you know, with the cars and with the
it
suits.
It was set around the 30s,
yeah, something like that.
Yeah,
with the gangster suits and the Tommy guns and stuff
yeah,
like that.
Yeah.
And also, I just like that it's there are so many ways to play the game because you know, of course, you have to interrogate people and you have to read off their facial expressions to see if they're lying mm-hmm. or if they're telling the truth or if they're doubtful. I think mm-hmm. that was the third option.
Yeah,
and like also you have to collect clues and stuff as well. So if you miss things, it will depend on that. Your chances of solving the case would depend on whether you can get info or not. So if you can't interrogate people properly or you miss some clues, then you will fuck up the case or catch the wrong person.
Yeah, that's one aspect of the game that I really like, the fact that, you know, it's kind of like Phoenix Wright, the Ace Attorney games.
Those
are
good.
If you don't have enough evidence, you can't really crack the case. But like here, you can't finish the case, but yeah. you will have like the wrong results. Yeah. And you're gonna have to live with it.
And also, like, and
you're
also,
have
like,
to live with it. Okay.
You also like get promotion if you do it right, but and then your superiors will also act differently towards you if you get a case wrong or if you get it completely right.
Ah.
Like he will punish you. He will like, or not punish you, but like shame you if you mm-hmm. like catch the wrong criminal or kill civilians or something like that.
It sounds kind of cool. I've always yeah. wanted to play, but I never got to it. I don't know why.
Maybe it'll be up for on the Steam sale or whatever.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
It takes some commitment, but it's a fun game to play.
Oh, I'm not a very committed person.
Next one is from Katarina, who's also in the chat joining us today. If you want to watch a message received live, it happens every week during Big Red Lazor. And while we don't, you know, check the chat because we want to focus on these messages, you can join in on the conversation with everyone else and answer the questions between yourselves in the chat. So be sure to do that. And she wants to know, this one's for you, Hilda.
Mm-hmm.
Hitchin, I know you have a lot of funny nicknames. Can you name your top five?
Oh my God, I have so many nicknames. It's ridiculous. Okay, I don't have like a top. Can I just name five
sure.
that I like?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
I used to be called Hillbro Baggins by my friends. Hillbro. Then most people on Twitch call me Hilly. I don't know why. I hate that. I hate Hilly. It's stupid. Don't call me that. My manager at work calls me the Hills. The Hills have eyes. I don't know why.
Wow.
Yeah, it is weird. Then I like Katarina's one, which is Hilchen. I can't even say that. Is Hilchen? I don't know. I don't even know how she made that up. It's weird.
It's a typical German.
It's like Mädchen. Word. Mädchen. Like,
yeah, Mädchen, Kaninchen, everything-chen.
Chien.
You know, tattoo-chen, camera-chen.
Camera-chen.
Yeah, you know. Yeah.
Beer-chen.
And then,
Beer-chen.
Yeah, beer-chen. And then, of course, there's Hirudaru, which
yes.
I...
Yeah.
Which is the one Tamtu made up, which yep. I really enjoy, and I will use it forever.
It is.
And the one I recently made up, I thought it was hilarious, Andrew didn't, was Childa.
Childa.
Netflix and Childa.
Exactly. That's what I said. And he was like, eh. It's like, that was funny. Don't.
So, you know, because he didn't laugh, there was no Netflix and Childa for exactly. him at all.
Exactly.
Patchy beard. Not laughing at your jokes.
Yeah. No Netflix and chill.
Duh.
So that was four, I think.
No, those were like six.
No, six. That was six.
Six, wow.
Yeah, and there's many, many more.
That was a bonus one for you right there, exactly. Katarina. All right. Daniel Delgado.
Hello.
Daniel.
Our buddy Daniel Delgado wants to know, Warcraft movie, yay or nah? How are your own experiences with Warcraft, the franchise, anyway?
I have never in my life played World of Warcraft. I haven't given in to the temptation.
Have you played Warcraft 3, though?
No.
The real-time strategy games that came before it.
The Warcraft, no, I haven't played any of those. The first Blizzard game I ever played was Heroes of the Storm, actually.
Okay. Same. Yeah,
I've never been much of a PC gamer, anyway. Mm-hmm. So I know Diablo was on console, but I've never played it.
I kind of have like a veto for Blizzard. I just don't go anywhere near them. I don't know why. It's just like I've never actually like played any of their games. Like no World of Warcraft, no Warcraft 3, not even Heroes of the Storm.
It's not like I have something against Blizzard. Exactly. It just doesn't same.
It just like
me,
I just
I guess.
Don't I just I've never played anything from them. But I mean like to answer your question, Warcraft movie, you know, I really do like the idea that they're bringing games into movies. I like that. Like,
but
if it's
will
done,
it work though?
Yeah, exactly. But it has to be done properly as well.
It's directed by Duncan Jones, the son of David Bowie.
Okay, and, so does that make it?
I think I do believe he's a pretty good director.
Yeah,
I can't list any other of his other movies off the top of my head right now. But what I saw in the trailer, people think it's a lot of CG, and it's partially CG, of course.
Yeah.
I wanted to say GG, but...
GG.
but there are also a lot of practical effects, and I read a lot of articles about the actors being part of the movie that they enjoyed on being on set because they actually made practical sets for everything.
Oh, yeah.
So...
doesn't look bad. I like movies, and I might watch it. I mean, why not?
Yeah, to me, as long as they, you know, as they make... If they make a movie out of a gaming world that I think is really beautiful and awesome... I think that's great already. Like, for example, like the only movie that I really want them to make is Bioshock. Not even Infinite. Rapture. Yes. I want them to make Rapture.
You know how
awesome that would be.
Both.
Like really, that would be the movie that I would be waiting for.
I was
for.
Just thinking that. I was seriously thinking Bioshock movie.
Yeah, exactly.
I might be alone in this, but I actually enjoyed the Prince of Persia movie.
I haven't seen those.
You actually like that movie?
Yeah. Wow. I mean, it had Jake Gyllenhaal.
Gyllenhaal. Yeah. No, I mean, that makes a movie better anyway, so. Yeah,
exactly right.
He has a good beard.
I don't know.
He has a beautiful beard.
He has a beautiful face.
So, Warcraft movie, I'm excited for it. I'm
going
to see it.
I'm going in there with an open mind.
Yeah,
I want to see it, so.
Yeah, same.
Okay. Next one is from Taj Garou. He wants to know, hi, Zoomin Games crew. Mortal Kombat X seems to be popular among the Zoomin team, but will any of you will be getting into other fighting games like Street Fighter V, Tekken 7, and The King of Fighters 14 that are scheduled to come out in 2016? Street Fighter V.
Street Fighter V. Pokken Tournament.
But no Street Fighter V. This time, I have to say, because of Tekken 7. I've always been a Tekken player.
Mm-hmm.
I've played Tekken 3, Tekken Tag, Tekken 5, and now I really am looking forward to Tekken 7.
I played Tekken 6. I really enjoyed that. But I am definitely a Street Fighter person.
Rao is going to hate me for this, but I want to play Tekken 7 for the story. he claims that, you know, fighting games have no story.
Yeah.
That is kind of true.
Kind of true, but there is a backstory to it, and I'm, you know,
I'm always interested though in the backstory of the characters. Yeah.
Yeah, so that's the only reason for me to want to play Tekken 7 because the Mishimas, they're gonna go in deeper into that storyline. It's like, okay, sure, sure, let's do this. Mishimas.
Hey, but guys, don't forget Pokken Tournament, which I am looking forward to.
I'm pretty excited.
I'm
for
fascinated by that.
Yeah.
I like it was when I first saw the trailer for that. I was like, this is my entire life. It's like a fighting game. It's Pokemon. It's everything, and it was.
Rather like than giving them commands, you can control.
I nerdgasmed. That is the best thing I've ever seen.
All right. Pokken Tournament, Street Fighter V.
Street Fighter V.
All right. The last one is from Minhas Udin. They want to know, if you were in a zombie apocalypse, which weapon from any game would you use? Hilda.
Oh, wow.
Flamethrower from Destiny. The thing.
Destiny doesn't have
Flame thing. There's a flame thing in Destiny that I use. It's like a scorch. The scorcher, that's the thing.
Oh, the scorch cannon.
I would fucking scorch cannon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know you can charge it, right?
I know.
It's so beautiful.
Scorch cannon.
Destiny nerds.
Scorch. Yeah, well, what weapon would you use?
Fat man. From Fallout 4.
Oh.
The Fallout fat man?
Boy. Seriously.
That's not a weapon? Is that a weapon?
Yes.
Oh, I thought
it launches mini nukes. You know how cool that is? Like, seriously, you have literally a...
Now I get it.
A hand cannon with a fucking mini nuke in it. So seriously, if I see a bunch of zombies grouped together, because they're always grouped together, I'm just going to be like, ha, boom,
confused about this. People kept saying to me, I found a fat man over there. And I was like, why is that interesting? It's just a fat man, but no, it was a weapon. Okay.
No, a fat man is a mini nuke launcher.
Games.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mini nuke launcher. Yeah.
And what about you, Tamtu?
Mm-hmm. The exotic swords from Destiny.
Oh, Destiny.
Yep.
Destiny.
Now that, or the gunblade from Final Fantasy VII.
Oh.
Final Fantasy VIII.
Did you just say that wrong time too?
Oh. Oh my gosh.
I had Cloud Strife on the brain for some reason, and so I said VII.
Because of the remake.
Yes. But gunblade, you know, it's a sword, and if you run ammo, you can still use it as a sword, and if you have ammo,
you can shoot it.
You can shoot it. Two.
That is kind of nice.
Gunblade.
Only reason I know it is because of Kingdom Hearts.
Exactly. Because of Leon.
Yes, Leon.
All right, and that's it for this week's message received. Woo! As I toss away the card so beautifully. If you have questions for the Zoomin Games crew, like us, or Tim, or Robert, or if he's... he should be here the first week of January. He might be joining us for Big Red Lazor then.
Or Kate.
Or Kate, you know. be sure to post them in the app. Or on social media, wherever you post it, be sure to use the hashtag message received, and we'll pick out a few to cover them in the show. Hilda, Viet, I want to thank you for being here to answer these questions, and we will see you next time. And we're going back to Big Red Lazor.
Why did we both just slap your legs?
Yes, we did.
Synchronized.
Yeah. Oh, man. So... 2015 is almost over.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. We've got our Game of the Year weeks coming up, where we have our Game of the Year content. Without spoiling anything from what we've discussed, what games have made the biggest impression on you this year?
Until Dawn.
Mm-hmm.
And Ori and the Blind Forest, I think.
Yeah. It made you cry.
Did it? Oh, it did. It may
or
have.
Or was it just the fact that that stream was just so overwhelmingly
horrible?
Positive?
Overwhelmingly.
Overwhelmingly. No. I actually think that Ori made me cry in the beginning. So I'm not a heartless person. I cry because of things. Just not Life is Strange.
Yeah, that one ended up being pretty strange.
Hey!
Yeah. Besides Fallout 4.
No. Actually, Fallout 4 met my expectations, so it didn't really, you know, wow me that much. What really did wow me was...
I'm asking about leaving a lasting impression.
Oh, a lasting impression. Yeah, okay, of course, Fallout 4, but... what really left a lasting impression on me was actually The Witcher 3, because I played The Witcher 2, and I really did not like it because it was so clunky. I didn't really want to get into that world for some reason. But I gave it a go with Witcher 3, and I actually got into it for quite a long time. Like, I love open world games. Like, they're just my thing. Because
we are opposites.
Yeah.
I hate open world games.
Yeah, because I don't know, like, for me, the idea of just, you know, just wandering off and doing other things and, you know, just meeting new people everywhere and getting, like, new quests everywhere, doing things, it's just really fun. And I guess, you know, it gives you a lot of options to do things.
I might as well play an RPG for that.
Yeah, maybe, but
at least that's a little bit more linear in a way. Not yes. too much freedom. Just give me yes. no direction at all.
I feel you.
Right.
I feel you.
I want freedom, guys. I want to do everything.
All right. Hey, now that we have this connection, though.
Wait, what is yours?
Huh? Yeah. What is yours?
Until Dawn.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Until Dawn is like.
I feel you, man. Yes.
I like my stories.
We feel each
other. I like my storytelling to be good. And being part of that, you know, that experience mm-hmm. in that game was just, you know, being so immersed yeah. was great. It doesn't matter that the gameplay in it was just QTEs the whole time.
And,
making
yeah.
choices. But the experience around it, yeah. I wasn't distracted by anything else.
Exactly. And I always get that with games. And that was one of the games that I was just like, I need to know what's going on.
I did a, like, complete stream. Like, beginning to end stream.
Yeah.
Like 8 hours.
7 hours.
Like, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, I got into it, and I was just only watching his streams.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it was really good.
I mean, I was playing all the games on the side, but, you know.
Oh, okay. Robert is very active in the chat right now. Oh. He says, guys, the only way to kill zombies for real, BFG. Get the BFG.
The what?
The big fucking gun.
Oh.
He's just excited about the Doom Alpha.
Oh, yeah. Oh, of course.
Oh. Yeah.
Yep. Okay, it's time for our next segment, and a segment that we are bringing back. And I think this has been an event 6 months in the making.
Mm-hmm.
You were there too.
I was there.
This is actually the perfect moment, the best time to bring back the challenge.
The yeah. challenge.
It's like it all comes together. Like when we had this, all three of us were there.
Mm-hmm.
And now all three of us are here again. Let's roll a video because I want to show you what I'm talking about right now.
I'm pro at every game.
I'm so down.
Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah? Bitch.
It's on.
Oh,
it's on.
Oh, you're going down, Tamtu.
So, it's time for our rematch, Hilda.
At last.
At long last. It's time for the Super Mario Maker rematch. Now, the way we did it at the post E3 event was we both made a level and we had to clear it, but we tied.
No, we didn't. I won.
If I remember correctly, Hilda won because she actually completed her level.
So did I.
But you took like 20 minutes more or something like that, right?
I did not complete the level, I think.
Wait, what? Wait, which one are you talking? Are we talking about here? The first one or the one at Gamescom?
We did one at Gamescom?
Yeah.
No, the Super Mario Maker Challenge post E3 event.
Oh, that one. Okay.
No.
Jesus.
Wow. You're mixing up events. Yet.
I'm really
you're
leave.
Mixing up events. Do you know how many events I have? All
right. So, thanks to the help of our of intern Eric. Who's not an intern anymore, by the way?
What?
Woo!
He's
Eric.
Not?
Eric!
No. Apparently, so I've heard.
Yeah.
Oh.
He selected three levels. Now, what we're going to do is we're both going to play. Viet, I need you to time the...
Can I win that?
No.
Oh.
This is ours. You're not touching it.
No. It's part of the part of the challenge.
You need to time? You want me to time?
Yeah. We're going to play through each level.
Yeah.
Both one at a time. We're going to complete it. You're going to keep score of the time.
Mm-hmm.
Whoever beats it the fastest wins that round. We will do a best of three. So whoever wins twice first.
I should have stopped.
This is the worst idea ever. Do you know how bad I am at fucking platformers?
I'm terrible at this as well. I have no idea what the levels are like. Now, the thing is...
Shit.
We have... Whoever goes first, the other person cannot see the level.
Yes.
Just to keeping things fair, and that's why,
that's
we,
why
have,
we have this.
We have. That's why we're also bringing back the Hat of Shame.
I wanted you to play my level.
Oh, you made
if
a level.
If we have time, we. I, yeah. I'll,
yes.
We can do that.
Yeah.
Next time you're here.
No.
First, this challenge. Okay. Yes. All right.
So I'm keeping this.
No. Well. Okay. Who's gonna? Who? How are we gonna decide who goes first?
We can toss a coin, I guess.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Oh, or rock, paper, scissors.
One, two, three. Damn it. Okay. So you go first.
Hat.
I will cover my eyes with the Hat of Shame.
Why is it shame? I like it. It's cute.
And we will start off with... Can you go to...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, this is the worst idea ever.
Yeah.
Well, Eric, I hate you.
Easy Pac-Man Deluxe.
Easy Pac-Man Deluxe.
Yes.
Okay.
Is it easy?
It and Deluxe.
All right. Do you have your phone
yes,
ready
I
for
have
time?
My phone.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Viet. Whenever.
One sec. I need to get my hair off my face. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. I cannot see anything. I took off my glasses, so I am waiting for stuff to happen.
Okay.
Can all I right. go?
Yes. Go.
Oh wait, it has to play. I have to start play. Oh, this is so horrible.
And the time's not gonna start until you actually end the level. So.
Okay.
And go.
No. How many tries do we get?
Until you finish.
What? This is gonna take 500 hours. Oh.
If you play like that, yeah.
I mean, can you just not? Go away. What the
right
fuck?
I'm just trying to imagine what Andrew's patched beard looks like.
Patched?
It's
his
weird.
Patchy beard.
Yeah. Oh, I love
and
how
comparing it to Dennis's epic Viking beard.
Yeah,
well, I mean,
I don't think there's any beard that compared to Dennis's at the moment.
Oh shit! This is
okay.
Not...
Let's just say you have 10 tries in total, then, okay? Because now you're on try number 3. Okay, yeah, we'll just say you're on try number 3 and you have 10 tries.
See, I'm not cheating like Eric did in the last Big Red Lazor.
Oh my
season.
Gosh.
In the season finale.
I can literally see nothing.
I love the comments people are putting. Like, basically, the first one was like, die. Die, please. Oh, hey.
Hey.
Yeah, she's done.
I did it.
She's done.
I'm done.
Wait, hold on. No, we have to go back to the menu first. Course clear. Exit.
Exit.
Yes. And are we back? Yes. Okay, you can take it off now, Tom, too.
What? We're done?
Yeah, we're done. Okay.
So wait,
so
you're the one who has to wear the hat all the time?
No.
We'll go paper, scissors, rock next again.
Okay, yeah. Cool.
Exactly.
All right.
Okay, so Hilda's time. Do you want me to say
no,
the time?
No. Oh,
okay.
No,
all right. Okay. So,
all right, so we're going for easy Pac-Man Deluxe. All
yes.
I have to do is hit play?
Yes.
All right.
What? Wait,
no.
What?
Oh,
no.
No.
Go back, B.
How?
You go back. Oh,
no!
Courses.
Eric!
Courses. You know, just courses.
I win.
And then
star ranking. Oh, my God. Time two.
Oh, my God. Oh, you can search for it. Top right. Top right. Yeah. And then just, yeah.
No. No, time
I'm
two.
Just messing everything up right now.
Yeah.
Not courses. Course world. Course world?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, guys.
This fucking guy.
Okay.
Oh.
Ah, there we go. Easy Pac-Man Deluxe.
Okay.
There we go.
Play.
Okay.
All right. How did you do?
I think she did all right.
Okay.
Okay, remember 10 tries and time starts.
Die, please.
Yeah, exactly. I love those comments. It's like...
I mean...
Oh,
no. Denim.
Denim. Yeah. Fuck.
I have no idea where I'm going.
I'm Tam 2. I suck at this. I'm Tam 2.
Woo!
Wow! Get wrecked! Get wrecked.
I think I just got lucky.
Get wrecked.
I died like 4 times.
Yeah. that's why I kind of set the limit to 10. Because she was dying so much.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, so, yeah. I mean, you guys can probably already guess the result. It's like, okay, so Hilda, you finish in a time of 1 minute and 14 seconds. Tamtu, you finish in 34 seconds. So, you were 30 seconds quicker than Hilda, and you didn't die at all. So, yep, round 1 goes to Tamtu. All right. So, we're going to go off to the next one, which is called 60 seconds, which is the third one down.
All right.
And you guys have to go rock, paper, scissors to see who go first.
1, 2, 3.
Yeah, Tamtu goes first. So, Hilda, you're going to need to cover your eyes. Aww.
I really don't see anything. Cute. Don't worry about it.
All right.
What?
Nothing.
My eyebrows are fading.
Fading?
Not the eyebrows.
Not the eyebrows.
Not the eyebrows.
Okay, so 60 seconds. Oh.
It's too big Niggy. For my head.
By Niggy. Time starts.
What the? That comment! Screw you, comment!
Whoa!
Wait.
Oh my god, I can hear this is going to mess me up already.
Why did I not jump? Oh, that's the jump button.
What the hell did you press time to?
I press B.
Yeah, that's that shoot.
Booze! No!
I love how you can see where people die. So, like, people die at that boo the most.
There are boos. There's boos.
I hate Eric.
I should have just. Okay. I got. Okay. 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 I got.
Let's try number 2.
All right, I got it. I got it. That comment is pissing me off.
Yeah, no, that comment was put there on purpose. I love that.
It's like a dick pic.
Yeah, exactly.
Dick pic.
Nice. He actually spent a lot of time on that comment. That's
what happens when you lose?
When you lose, no, another.
Then the winner gets to create the next challenge.
That's try number 4.
No, I think that was 5.
Oh, okay, 5. Or are you trying to?
No, I really think it was 5.
Oh no, yeah, because he. Okay, yeah. Okay, yeah, that was 5.
I'm an honest person, guys.
Hilder is a very honest person.
Yeah. Oh my god, I'm going to fail so hard. I don't even know what's happening and I'm going to fail so hard. I would probably still fail if I saw the level right now.
No need to. What? What the?
He's trolling you, bro.
It's like I've never played the new Super Mario game, so. The wall jumping mechanics, which aren't there, by the way.
Thank God. Aren't? Or are?
I don't know.
You're running out of time, Tamtu.
I know!
I shouldn't say anything. I really shouldn't say anything.
You only have 60 seconds?
Yes, that's why the level is called 60 seconds.
Oh my god.
Okay, so, okay, that's try number 6 gone as well.
Seven. That was 7.
Yeah.
7.
I was going to say the previous one. So yeah, this is try number 8.
Come on!
Okay. Alright, boo part. You forgot about that boo again.
Boo!
Hashtag Tamtu rage.
Only with Nintendo games, man. Only with Nintendo games.
I know,
games.
Man.
Try number 9.
Why? Why did I do that? Why?
One more time too. I think.
Yeah, just one more. Yeah.
Oops.
I forgot this part. All right. This is going much better.
It is?
It's going much better.
I hope you die.
Well, if he dies, basically he can't try anymore. So.
Exactly. So I hope he dies. Then I automatically win.
No.
What? No. Yes.
Wee.
Whoop!
Oh, no.
All right. So
okay.
It's so basically who gets the farthest right now.
Yeah,
if she gets farther,
exactly.
She wins, right?
Yeah. If she gets further, then she wins.
Oh, I just took off my mic. Can I?
Yeah, just put it back on again.
Can I look? Oh.
Yeah.
This one's rough.
Need my glasses,
yeah.
Guys. I want to wear the hat. Let me just
okay,
wear
go
the
ahead.
Hat. I want to wear the hat. I like wearing hats, guys. You know that.
Is it that for good luck?
No, it mm-hmm. smells.
You don't know where it's been.
I know. That's what's concerning me a little bit.
Okay.
Were you looking on the big screen or on the
big screen?
On the this screen. Okay.
Whatever you want.
Yes. All right, go.
Oh my god.
Why doesn't it fucking...
Because you have to dash.
What's dash?
Hold X.
Yeah.
Well,
what is
that?
Try number one.
Huh? X? Oh.
How did someone die all the way up there? I don't... Oh, he wall jumped. That's why. Let's try number two.
What is...
Yeah.
Somebody spent time doing that, guys. Come on. Give us some credit.
How the fuck do I do that? Huh?
That's three.
I forgot to jump.
I forgot how to jump.
Hope. No, she forgot to jump.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not time to. I know how to jump.
Ooh.
Okay, now what?
Now you jump. There we go.
Oh. You jump, like,
four.
On purpose when you don't need to, I think.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I think it's like an automatic reaction that you get. If you see something, you're like, oh, jump.
Yeah.
It's small, Mario.
Huh? Like, it doesn't do it. I pressed jump.
Uh-huh.
I did.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Nice.
Pretty sure.
When in doubt, blame the controller.
Yeah. Exactly. I'm just gonna do it like that. It doesn't jump when you press X.
It doesn't jump when you press X.
No.
It's supposed to press A.
I know, but I still had X, like...
This is try number 7.
No, it's not.
Yes.
No, it's not.
Yes.
See? What is my life?
Gone. That's
yeah.
what it is.
Yeah.
So what this is try number 7?
No, this is try number 8. Nice try. You also died on that guy the first time.
That piece of shit, though.
Try number 9. Okay, we're done.
No.
I win!
One more.
What?
Wait, one more. Sorry. I can't count today. I don't know why.
Yeah, it's not like 9 is the last one. 10 is. God damn it.
This is like the worst level to do.
What? It doesn't fucking jump! Okay.
Okay. Alright.
So.
Yeah.
Rematch settled.
Yeah. It's still a tie. Didn't she win the first one? Or did you win the first one?
Crushed the first one. I won this one by making it the furthest.
I'm so bad with numbers today, guys.
So
yeah, so
it means
that's settled now, guys.
The rematch has been settled.
Yes, the rematch is settled. I guess Tom 2 won this round.
Yeah, but you wouldn't have finished my level.
Really?
Really.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a challenge?
That is a challenge.
All right. So we got round
three. We'll save it then for the next time.
All right.
When you're back. I think it's time for
our third item for today, which is Rainbow Six Siege.
Oh.
And we went to an event. The top secret one in Warden.
Of all places.
But it was really awesome. So check out this video that we made of that event.
A vlog.
So we are once again back in Warden, in the middle of nowhere, a little bit. And we're here because Ubisoft. And for what? We don't know yet, because this is a mystery event. They told us just to be here at the station and just to wait for them. So I'm excited, you know. I'm hoping for Far Cry Primal, but you know, you never know. They just told us to wait here, so I guess we'll have to wait and see. You notice that I'm here alone? That's because Tamto hasn't arrived here yet. His train got delayed, so hopefully he'll arrive on time.
So I'm back in Warden, and I'm super, super, super late because someone decided to jump from a train. So Yet's already here. He's already at the event, and I still have no idea what game it is. So yeah, we'll see what it is.
Tamto's still AFK, so for now, I'll be enjoying everything alone.
One abandoned building. I have no idea what it is still. Shukri from Ubisoft guided me here. But I still have no idea what it is. We saw one other press guy, and he was impressed, said it was unforgettable. So the hype is real right now. Super real.
Bro,
I have never felt so badass before. Shit was intense. I took out the boss. I might be bleeding internally and dying, but I took out the boss. So that's all that matters, right? It's all about the mission. Good job, guys. Good job. GG. Yeah.
Yeah.
The real victim today, my glasses.
Okay, guys, I'm trying to get some Rainbow Siege on. Rainbow Six Siege. Can never get it right.
Kill some terrorists.
Yeah, I'm gonna kill some terrorists just the way I did before.
OD!
Because I have the scars to prove it. See? The scars!
Okay, we're headed out, and I fixed my glasses. Rainbow Six Siege, really? It's cool if you have a team that you can rely on. Not when someone else blows you up, right, Viet?
Yes. Someone blew me up because he got the wrong window. I told him I'm gonna breach this window and he has to breach the other one. But he breached the wrong one, so I died.
Rainbow Six Siege coming out soon, I think. Ish, we'll talk about it. But it's coming out on Xbox One, PS4, and PC. We play it on PC right now. And they had some really sweet rigs. And the headsets were cool. But yeah. Thanks again, Ubisoft, for inviting us to this. I did film something while I was there during the thing, but I've never felt so badass, guys.
I'm very jealous.
Next time, Viet.
Jelly.
Next time.
So jelly.
On. On, you noblest men. Once more unto the breach, dear friends. Once more.
Rainbow Six Siege. On.
Uh-huh.
On, my brothers.
Oh, so as you can see, these are different glasses.
Mm-hmm.
There's no tape, no duct tape right there. And yeah, that was a really cool event. It was top secret. And it was that whole situation thing with Hell Shooter.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Hell Shooter Hell, Het Echte Leven, which means the real life. So if you were translated to English, it would be the troll shooter. Or something like that. But it was a really cool event. And I think we should, as a crew, we should go there
to
do it.
I think
IRL.
Yeah, that's because you get to do it. I didn't get to do it, so I
want
to.
I want you guys to experience it too. Like,
it's really
actually
awesome.
Wear the gear, shoot at terrorists, and just.
I would love to do that.
Yeah,
can we please do that?
Let's do it, Robert. Put it in the budget for next year.
We're going to Warden again.
Yes. Lights out,
Warden.
All right, it's time to play some Rainbow Six Siege. I said soon when the video was recorded. It was actually recorded a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
But it's been out this week, and now we're gonna play it for you.
Yes.
So Viet,
I tried this yesterday, and it was fun. But the problem is I didn't have PlayStation Plus yesterday, so you can only play alone. And it's just not fun alone. Apparently when you unlock a class, you get a cutscene. That's pretty cool. So I just unlocked Thatcher. Oh, there we go.
Can we just talk about what this game is about? Because tried to explain it to me and I didn't get it.
Okay, well, basically it's like it's like a situation where it's terrorists against counter-terrorists. And the terrorists are usually hauled up in a building with either a bomb, hostages, or it's just deathmatch where you just try to kill each other.
Okay.
And it's very tactical because you have to really work with your team. both teams to kill the other teams off, because the counter-terrorists start outside and they try to infiltrate a building and complete the objectives while the terrorists defend it. So yeah, let me just jump into one.
So basically it's just a super fancy Counter-Strike Go, but for consoles.
Yeah, that is what it was like. It's CSGO, but more elaborate.
Exactly.
Okay. More fancy. Yeah.
More
fancy. Because it's written by Tom Clancy.
Hey, Mayo.
Oh, hey, it rhymed.
Exactly.
Oh, really? What?
All right.
Prime Black Dodo says hi.
Hi, Dodo.
Oh,
can I just take this moment to publicly apologize for saying something rude about my boyfriend's beard? Because I made him I made him cry, and that is not what I wanted.
He's watching, isn't he?
He is.
Okay.
We love you, Andrew.
We love you.
Have a great beard.
Yeah.
Don't be ashamed.
You have more beard than I do.
Exactly. You have more beard than these two guys together.
Oh, wait, what? Okay, so how do I join? Oh, wait, why am I in support mode? I want to join. Okay, well, anyway. So, yeah. See, these are my teammates. They're the counter-terrorists, so now they're breaching inside.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this is... I don't know if this is... Oh, this is just team deathmatch, I think, that you have to kill the other teams. These are the breach charges. So someone blew that up in my face.
You still have to join, apparently, see? Because there's a question mark there.
Where?
At the top.
Oh, right. But how do I...
Start?
Wait, there we go. Charge is active. No, I guess they're just playing.
Oh, you joined a game in progress or something?
No.
I think so. Okay, so, well, let's just wait this round out. Because now... Oh, yeah. This is basically... Wait, let's see. Objective found.
Security objective.
Okay, so they're breaking the wall, so then we can probably see. Charge active. Because I don't know which mode this is, I just joined a random game.
Objective is 30 meters away.
13.
Cookie boy!
Cookie boy! Cookie boy is dying! Wait, this is like, capture the headquarters thing.
Oh.
Yeah.
Boom, 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 boom.
I want you in my room.
Let's blow up shit together, together in my room.
Friendly, last operator standing. Oh, damn, that sucks. I think he went into a room with a bomb in it, that's why.
GG.
You can set traps here as well as a terrorist. And as a counter-terrorist, you also have a class where you can, like, either hack those traps or disable them.
Mm.
So it's really tactical.
Man, so much to think about.
Exactly.
I just want to shoot people.
Exactly, but that's why, like, you know, that's why I said in the video, you know, it's fun. We said in the video, it's fun if you have a team that you can rely on.
Yeah.
But if not, it's kind of difficult to play this game. Okay, so that's one versus... Oh, no! He reloaded! Oh, he reloaded! Oh, my God.
You don't reload while not in cover!
That's my problem, too. Like, I reload after two shots. It's like, oh, crap. I shouldn't do that. It's not good for you. Okay.
You're basically being caught with your pants down.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, so this is my only class that I have, so let's do it. Let's be Russians. Spetsnaz.
Did you just not turn off your vibration?
That was not my phone.
Oh.
Could be this phone. Yep.
That's a shotgun. I have tons of stuff. Hey, don't throw my phone.
Throw his phone.
I was gently bumping it away.
Throw it far away.
Oh, cool. Crouch high.
Just play deathmatch, man.
Yeah, no, this is deathmatch. Like, if you kill the other team, you win, basically. So... But like, yeah, but
you also have to do stuff?
Yeah, no, but that's the thing with Rainbow Siege. It's very slow-paced. So, you know.
It does look nice, though. I like the way it looks.
Oh,
when I play this type of game, I can, like, forget all the things
that
I have to do.
All the objectives?
Yeah, it's just you have to think of so many things.
What else do I have? I have...
I get too distracted.
Oh, I have barbed wire that I can set down.
Do it.
How do I do that?
Do it. Just do it.
I have no idea.
Just do it! It looks much better than the alpha, obviously.
Well, yeah, that's because it was an alpha.
Yeah.
I'm just saying, boy.
There we go.
Okay. Yeah, deploy it right in the middle of that guy's feet.
Dude,
yeah,
why not?
Do it.
Because why not?
Why the fuck not?
Because you can.
Juanito B. Juanito B.
Juanito. He's from Belgium, Juanito, apparently.
Yep.
Or he just is.
All right, so there's a lot of Dorna love.
Oh, Dorn is in
Dorna
there.
Dorna love. Dorna love.
Is Dorn in there?
Mm-hmm.
People are loving her?
Apparently.
Reinforce this shit.
Hi, babe.
Wait, why are
you... That reminds me, I need to check up on my cats.
Your cats?
You have cats?
Oh, yes, me too.
Oh, my God.
We should play Nico Atsume on stream.
These guys. These. So, yeah. Oh, wow. We just died. One of them died.
How are your cats doing?
Not visiting. All right.
Oh, there we go. Wow.
What was that? There was this whole thing sticking out of the wall.
It's like
it was like a glory hole.
Hey! That would be awesome.
Death replay. Oh, they threw a grenade. Damn.
Threw that.
That sucks.
Pipe.
Yeah.
Thing.
Yeah, I guess like when you get like the thing, when you unlock more classes, you get more awesome weapons and stuff.
Mm.
Oh.
Yeah, I've been watching people play Rainbow Six the past week a few times. Looks like fun, but I want people to play with.
Yeah, no, that's the thing. You're like, you really
voice chat.
You really have to get into it with people that you know. Otherwise, like, oh.
I like playing this type of games with people I know anyway.
Oh my God.
Mm-hmm.
People.
You're doing well.
Dude, I haven't done anything, literally.
But what you did well.
Yeah. Exactly.
Good
job.
You
barricaded that wall. Fantastically.
I'm proud of you, Viet. I am proud of you.
What's this? Oh yeah, this is the one that I unlocked. Yes, stun grenade. That's what I want. They all look pretty cool though.
Thatcher.
Sledge.
Fuse Blitz.
And recruit, hello.
You okay there?
You okay there?
I'm white, Mr. Angry. I'm the recruit.
I don't know.
Still new here.
Oh, sweet. Look at this.
I haven't unlocked anything, so.
I don't know what's happening right now.
Okay, so, yeah. Oh, yeah, you also get these, like, little.
Robots!
Car. Jesus. Robot car things.
Are those stupid Segway things that cool people stand on nowadays?
Oh, I'm out of here. Those hoverboards.
Hoverboards.
I'm out of here, bitches.
I hate those things.
So you can get to. You probably would have been here faster than waiting for the train.
Yeah.
I mean, probably. And it has lights and shit, so.
Yeah.
I mean.
Can't even go in the dark.
But is that what these things are?
No.
Oh.
These are just little drones.
No, yeah, these are little like drones that you can just
white
send
Mr. Angry.
And then mark enemies.
Mm. All right, so now we have to find the biohazard container.
Yeah.
It's like a bomb, like a poison bomb.
Yeah, something like that. And it kills a lot of people, so.
Oh. That's what bombs usually do.
Exactly.
That is what bombs are for. Except, like, smell bombs.
Smell bombs?
What do you call those?
Farts.
Yeah.
Smell bombs. No, not farts.
All right, let's breach.
Wow.
Oh, wow. 4 versus 5 already.
What was that?
What are you doing?
He was like,
breaking the damn barricade.
Hi. Hi. Hey.
Guilty.
Excuse
Ooh,
me.
A bar.
Get some drinks on. And a jukebox.
This game contains violence and alcohol. Rated M for mature.
Mature.
No. Hint at use of alcohol.
Mature.
Okay. We're fucked again.
Hey.
Rated V for V.
Don't give up, man. Just keep going.
Don't stop believing.
Oops, I just flashed myself.
Nice!
You know what, Viet? Just stop believing right now.
Yep, yep, he's dead.
Wow.
Got him.
Not a lot of spraying. No spraying there.
Hey, shut up. I killed him, okay?
No spray. This is money, guys.
This game is too stressful for me.
Stressful? Nothing is happening.
Yeah.
That's the problem. Nothing's happening.
Oh, the anticipation is killing
yes.
you. Yes. Oh. Mm. Oh, I think it's more the flash bombs that are...
I don't feel it, man.
No, me neither.
It looks cool.
Because you're cold.
Sensitivity is high. Holy crap.
What does that wall say? Oh, I found something out about myself and gaming recently.
What?
The reason I'm so bad at video games is because I always want to look at everything. So when I'm playing Call of Duty and I'm playing a map that I really like, I'm like, oh my god, this house is so pretty.
And then it's like, boom, you're dead.
Then I die. And that is what happens. So that's why I suck at video games, apparently. And because I'm bad, also.
Okay, let's
battle from us.
Let's go with
a real treat for you.
I mean, I don't care about Star Wars, so no, not
but
really.
But everything was pretty.
It looked pretty, but it was like, ooh, that's a pretty
spotted.
Bottle. There were no bottles there, it's just landscape. I will be like, what does this sign on the
You've
wall
been spotted
say?
Again. Who's
Where?
Spotted? Who's spotting me?
Huh?
And why can't I... Oh, Jesus. That's a trap, I guess.
What does that sign say, though?
Why does it keep saying I've been spotted?
What? Can they spot you via camera or something?
Maybe. Maybe they have a hacking class.
Maybe you can shoot the cameras. Is there a camera?
I don't know.
Juanito, he's talking. Juanito.
Yeah, I know. Juanito's talking to me, but
now,
I'm not.
If you guys want to play with us, the username is Zoomin_games.
Yeah.
And then join us if we're online.
Spotted again, like Jesus.
You can just stop being spotted.
Like, oh my god.
Oh my
stop
god.
Spotting me. I can't stand all this attention. Ooh, guns.
The pressure is real.
Ooh, where the hell are they?
He knows that everyone who's watching this right now is watching you play.
I know, and I suck at this game.
Yeah, you do.
I played yesterday
I mean, no,
and I couldn't
don't.
Even beat the freaking...
There were three guys standing right
no,
there.
That was those are dolls.
Oh my god, I'm just kidding.
My god. Stop putting me in this state. Oh.
Well, you lost.
Again.
I have no idea where they are.
Yes, show the most boring part of the round.
It's like...
That was... I have no words for that.
I just have no idea where they were.
Wow. All right, this was Team Deathmatch.
I got one kill. Hey. No, it's Team Deathmatch, but also like secure area or something.
All right, let's try a different mode.
No, I can't because the thing is, I basically just went on casual online, and then this is what I have to do. I mean, I could go to single player, but that's boring as hell.
Wait, can't you choose?
No. I literally just... Here. This is what I did. I went to multiplayer.
What is Terrorist Hunt?
Terrorist Hunt. Yeah, but this is... I think this is like LAN playing. Because it says here, matchmaking or invite friends.
Matchmaking. Go for it.
All right. That's just fucking matchmaking.
Yeah.
I think this is like Team Deathmatch, maybe.
Probably.
You gotta hunt the terrorist.
Terrorist. Is there anyone playing with me?
No. No one wants to play with
Dante
you.
Wants to play.
Dante Midnight. Oh, yeah.
You guys are weird.
So are you.
Yes.
True.
Weirdo.
Weirder. Oh, hey. We got a Dutch guy.
NL Alien.
Dutch Alien.
Your net type has been detected as strict. You may not be able to talk or hear other players in game.
Yes, I know.
Oh, knows. We just need one more player.
No, not two. Come on, man.
Irate customer, Dadin Who, R10.
Dadinho.
Dadin Who.
Redbone.
Oh, yeah. Let's go terrorist hunting. Oh, I gotta protect hostage now. Hostage.
Oh, God. It's like Office in CSGO.
I guess protecting would... Oh, wait, what? I can only go as recruit.
Okay, oh, that's okay.
That's fine.
Polizei.
Jawohl.
Hey, what is this hat supposed to be?
It's a Mario cat.
This is not a cat. This is like hamster or something.
Let's go SWAT this time. Oh, wait, never mind.
I'm done with this thing. It's over.
Yeah, it's moment.
It is.
All right, so terrorist hunt.
Go.
Let's see what this is all about.
Go.
CSGO?
No.
Oops.
No.
Oh, four ways. Okay, fortify the area.
I'll
fortify your area. Sorry.
Wow.
Sorry.
Just wow. I have no idea what to fortify.
Hey, it's Christmas.
Barricade. Hello? I want to put a barricade.
It's Christmas time.
Can I put a barricade, please? What's this? Oh, look.
A shield.
Boom.
Hey,
fuck yeah.
Look at that tiny ass shield, though.
I know, right?
Well, he needs something to shoot over. It's slow enough for cover, high enough for cover, tall enough for cover, I mean.
Yeah.
But low enough for him to shoot over.
All right, then.
All right, hey. I'm just putting my shield up there.
All right.
Oh, wait, there we go. Barricade.
Oh, it's a kitchen.
Barricade that shit, yo.
It's where you belong.
Put them staples in there, boy. Shoot on the things.
Oh.
Whoa, this is a really weird gun. The scope is weird. You can't see anything. Oh, don't shoot the wall.
I don't even know how to lean out with this. You can lean, but I don't know how.
Lean back.
I don't have any grenades of any kind.
Enemies eliminated.
Let's put some barbed wires.
Wait, I don't think this is against real people, or is it?
No, this is bots.
Oh.
Some barbed wires. Oh, are you barricading?
No, I don't know.
I want barbed wires. No, put it down. Reinforce the wall. You know what? Fuck this. The barbed wires can do whatever it wants.
Come on, Redbone. Right, want Dante Midnight.
The barbed wire just doesn't want to
deploy.
Where are you supposed to put it? Maybe you're not supposed to put it in like a door opening. Maybe. Oh.
There we go.
Now it's on the floor.
It's horrible.
Well done.
GG.
Well, I'm sorry. The game won't let me put it anywhere else.
Why did they not cover that hole.
Oh, really?
Really? Did you just?
Don't get in front of my way when I'm shooting.
In front of my way. Okay, come on. Hey, wait, is that his blood on the wall?
Possibly.
It's not mine.
That doesn't look like blood. It's too red. Oh,
I think they breached somewhere else. Oh, there we go.
Did your barbed wire do anything?
Yes. Slow them down.
Yes, it did. Well done. Don't you think this weapon looks really weird?
Yeah. It's the F9, I think it's called.
I don't care. It just looks weird.
Yeah.
Like when you aim down the scope, yeah. It like covers the entire screen.
Yeah, no, that's true.
The entire really screen.
Okay, can I like...
When you aim down the sight, you want to look at where you're aiming
anyway. Oh, yay, ammo!
Yeah, but it because you can't really even see your enemy anymore.
Because it's all about what you see in the scope.
I know.
More
barbed
wire.
That's not what I mean. Fiat knows what I mean.
I think I know what you mean. I don't know. I have no idea what you mean.
It's just a weird scope.
Yes. It is a weird scope.
It's a weird gun.
That doesn't make it a weird gun, though.
Is it a weird gun?
How does it control? I guess it's one of the default guns.
So
yeah.
You better get used to it.
Ooh, did you just get a kill?
I have kills.
You got a kill.
I got a double kill.
What?
I know, right? So happy.
I can tell.
You can feel the excitement.
I can tell. Yeah,
you sound
really happy.
Yeah, I don't know. This game is just you really need to get into it before it actually like becomes fun for you, because like you really need to have a team, and then you also need to really know like the maps and know what you're doing.
Can I shoot?
See, back in the day when I was really really bad at shooters, I would get so happy when I got a kill.
You're supposed to defend. Oh, there we go. Now you can barricade it. Okay.
Don't tell me what to do. I know what to do. I'm a gamer.
Oh, watch out.
No. I never watch out.
Watch out, no. Oh.
Can I shoot? Sure. Dies immediately.
Damn, I was
nice.
That was fun. I enjoyed that.
Boy.
This is why people like to watch me play games.
Because you die a lot.
This exact reason.
Fielder.
Yeah,
Fielder. Fielder. It's my new name. Fielder at work.
Ooh.
Ooh. It vanished.
No one saw it.
Magic.
You didn't see anything.
I did not miss the cash.
Oh.
I let it pass me.
What do you think, though?
Yeah, like I said, you know, this game, I'm pretty sure I could get into it if I actually spent time on it and had an actual team that I can play with.
I guess,
then it would be fun. But, this game, for me, just has, like, so much that you're so much dependent on, like, a good team that it's just not that fun anymore.
It's, for me...
You can't carry anyone.
No.
And it's, I like fast-paced. So,
yeah,
for me,
exactly.
It's, like, a little bit, just waiting.
Oh, here they come.
Yeah, this is way too slow-paced for me. Like,
yeah.
I'm so used to Call of Duty and Battlefield.
Me
you know?
Too. Like, since I've been playing Black Ops for the past weeks, I can't, like, this is so slow for me.
Exactly. And it's just, and also, like, I'm playing Counter-Strike Go right now, and it's just not the same feeling, you know, because Counter-Strike Go, you can still carry the team, and also you're not that dependent on your teammates. So, yeah, this game, you really need your teammates.
Yeah.
Otherwise,
it doesn't matter if you're good.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if you're good if the rest of the team is terrible.
Yeah. Four eliminated. Mission successful. Yeah, well, I guess.
See, even though I died, they still did well.
Go, GG, dad in who?
Dad in who?
Well,
wait, what?
You know, we protected the hostage. I would chalk that down as a victory.
Exactly.
As a good victory.
No regrets.
You got six kills.
Mm-hmm.
Six kills?
And I leveled up.
That is a lot for me, usually. Six kills.
And you gained renown. Yeah.
Exactly.
That was Rainbow Six. Siege.
That was Rainbow Six Siege for you.
Hmm.
Interesting.
Yeah. Interesting.
I think we need more time with it.
I don't think I want it.
No, I wouldn't get it either. No, this is just not my type of game. It's too slow.
It looks like, I think you can, it can be very competitive, and it looks like, yeah, if you're good at it and if you're into this type of game, you could be like,
yeah, but the thing with the old Rainbow Six games was that you could at least, you know, have someone else play with you split screen.
Yeah.
And then it would at least alleviate the loneliness of it.
Yeah, I guess so.
Or the forced matchmaking.
And right now, of course, you didn't have any contact with your teammates. I think it will be more fun if you have contact with them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, that's one of the core things in these kind of type of games.
Yeah.
Those call-outs. Call-outs.
Call-outs.
All right. And speaking of call-outs.
Mm-hmm.
Fallouts. Wait, what?
Chat. Call-outs in the chat.
Well, for once, this is not about Fallout.
Yeah. Well, people have been watching. People have been
telling me I suck.
No, they love us.
Yeah,
they ask if Black Ops 3 is any good.
I love it.
It's fun. Black Ops 3 is basically Advanced Warfare, but then
better.
But then, like, without exosuits, basically.
Mm-hmm.
It's Advanced Warfare without exosuits.
I haven't played Advanced Warfare. The last one I played is Ghost.
Oh my god.
And that was the worst thing ever. And before that, I played Modern Warfare 2 and 3.
Mm-hmm. That was
fun. And I was super obsessed with those games. And right now, when I'm playing Black Ops again, I just get those feels. The Call of Duty feels that I really missed. So I'm like playing it all the time. Like all the time. It's ridiculous.
I had like this one moment where I was really like, I was literally binging Call of Duty 4, the first Modern Warfare, every night. Like,
That's what I'm doing now. It's horrible. Don't get sleep.
I think I prestiged like 3 times in Call of Duty 4. I got like the golden guns as well. Like, yes. That's when you get like headshots on all, like full complete headshots on all the other guns. I was just rampaging with a shotgun.
Yeah.
And then I remember Modern Warfare 2 was also a lot of fun.
Modern Warfare 2 was great.
But then came the later Black Ops, like the later Call of Duty games, and I just couldn't get into them anymore.
Yeah, this one I'm finally.
This one was
loving it.
Advanced Warfare was also pretty fun for me.
For me, it was Call of Duty 2. Oh, I played multiplayer over local area network at a friend's place. At his office, actually. Yeah, they were done with working, and then everyone would just play Call of Duty 2.
Done with working.
Yeah.
Then I went to World at War,
which
I really enjoyed. Zombies in World at War. Yeah. So good.
Yeah.
That was so much
so
fun.
So good.
Mm-hmm. Then Black Ops 1. Then Advanced Warfare.
Yeah.
And briefly, Black Ops 3 from the events.
I got Black Ops 3 mainly for the zombies, but now I don't ever play zombies anymore at all.
Multiplayer.
Now I'm just all about multiplayer, hardcore, deathmatch, or kill confirmed. I'm just like, pew, pew, pew.
I'm pretty sure if I wasn't
I'm real bad, but it's fine. I'm
pretty sure if I wasn't so into Fallout 4, I would be playing Black Ops 3 as well.
Yeah.
So, to those that want to play with you,
yeah,
Black Ops 3,
yeah,
what's your username?
I played on PS4. You can add me with the username Hirudaru.
Hirudaru.
You just asked me that because you wanted me to say my PSN. Hirudaru.
Yeah. well, since you're playing it so much, would you say it's one of your favorite games of the year?
Personally, I guess maybe.
Top five? In your top five?
I think it is in my top five.
Yeah?
Yeah. I haven't finished the campaign yet, but I've heard that the campaign is actually really good for a Call of Duty game.
It's more extended.
More extended, better storyline, and just overall, there's more to do, which I like. Definitely. I always play the story mode. I don't know why, but people are always like, don't play the story mode, but I always play
Call of Duty. I always play story mode first, and then I go to multiplayer.
Yeah, it's fun. It's
remember
real
when we just basically binged Advanced Warfare's
we binged Advanced Warfare
story mode.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Basically.
I don't mind it. Everyone's always hating on the story mode, but I like it.
Yep.
It's pretty fun.
I play games for story, guys. And Destiny.
That was so annoying. Every time I'm on my PlayStation, I thought we were going to play Battlefront, and every time you're just playing Destiny. Destiny all the time.
Well, if you want to play Battlefront, just let me know.
No, it's fine. I like Destiny too.
Okay, good. Well, then why don't you ever invite me?
Iron Banana.
Wait, what?
Yes, Iron Banana. All right. Before we go, I want to thank you for joining us today.
Yes.
Thanks for coming here despite, you know, all your
I enjoyed it. I'm glad I was actually able to be at an entire... Wait, no.
No, you weren't here for the entire show.
No, but I'm never here for the entire show. But you never are, no. Usually I have to leave early, which sucks. Now I don't have to leave early, which gives me some kind of chill. Mm-hmm. So
chilled.
Chilled. I enjoy being here.
All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching us on Twitch today as well. We apologize for the technical difficulties earlier. We will throw this on YouTube, probably.
We will.
The archive version. And pop, stay tuned for, you know, message received, the video coming out. Kate wasn't here today, but she will be back very soon. Very, 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 very soon in Framerate, the new name for Community Highlights.
Woohoo!
So there are several things that you can submit to us. Your gameplay videos for Framerate. You can vote for the game of the year. For the community game of the year, so we can make the top five video of
this is important.
Yes. Your game of the year, your top five. Like usually, you know, Tim and Eric and Robert and we all decide, you know, what goes into this list. But now it's your turn.
And
which you can also submit stuff for.
I was gonna say that. You can also use the hashtag. What was it? Game news, right?
Game news in the app.
Game news in the app for game news that matter to you for turn based, mm-hmm. And also hashtag message received to ask us questions which we might answer.
Yeah,
might.
Yes.
Yes, because there are, you know, from the amount we do have to pick, and we are unlimited time.
Yeah. It's sad.
Yes. But that's why we just have to come back more often with this, do this every week. And maybe, if people like it enough, maybe we'll do this twice a week. I don't know.
Or,
Hashtag the dream.
The dream. Hashtag the dream. All right, that's it for this week's Big Red Lasers. Tune in back next week at 4 p.m. CET, which is 10 a.m. EST, 7 a.m. PST, whatever Australia time it is. I don't know. I'm sorry.
Or you can just Google it.
You can Google it. We'll be back next week. I'm Tamtu.
I'm Viet.
I'm Hilda.
At Childa. And that's it for Big Red Lazor. See you next week.
Thank you for watching.
Coming up this month at Zoomin Games is our Game of the Year content. And besides our upcoming group discussions and Top 5 Game of the Year, we are also bringing back the community Top 5 Game of the Year. Voting starts now and the link to the form is in the description below. You have until Sunday the 20th of December, midnight CET, to cast your vote. As soon as the clock hits 12 a.m. and it becomes Monday for us, we start gathering all this data and make the video of your game of the year.
Connect with the Zoomin Games community. Share your adventures with us every day. Upload videos and photos or create your own memes for everyone. Download the new Zoomin Games community app now for Android and iOS devices.